You may be surprised that it's really difficult to photograph during snow, but the big secret is that in the worst weather, you can get the best photos. So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you how to photograph in the snow, but the challenge here for myself is I'm only going to be using a 150 to 500 telephoto lens to try to do that. Now, I love adding stakes and challenge to everything, so if I'm not able to do this, if the photos don't turn out, let me know down in the comment section if it was good or bad, and if there are more bad votes than good, I'm not allowed to use my 150 to 500 for an entire month, which is trouble because I have a planned full moon photography shoot coming up soon. Now, the big problem with winter photography is that you want it to go fast as possible. And that's hard to do because in the cold, everything just really slows down because you've got extra gear and it is a toasty negative 10 degrees wind chill right now. So I'm trying to get out of this as fast as possible so I don't get any frostbite or anything like that. Check out this scene behind me right here. This is gonna be my first shot. Now, this may not look like much to you right now, but I can guarantee that this is going to be a good shot. Namely, when you're trying to do something with snow photography, you wanna think about, number one, your exposure. Number two, you wanna think about what the background actually is, especially when you're using something like a telephoto lens. So I can work my way around this scene of these pine trees back here, but what I'm looking for is getting a background with the least amount of distraction possible going on behind it. So I want all the green pine needles coming out of there, but I also want that dappling of snow, and there's the big trunk that kind of weaves its way up through the composition. I want to incorporate that too, because it has a nice side splattering of snow on the side of it that kind of acts like side light when you think about how the sun can hit certain parts of a tree and light it up. Snow can do the same thing for your compositions. So here's the photo that I was able to get. Let's move on and find another one because it is freezing and I want to be done with this challenge as fast as possible. All cold joking aside, I actually love being out in inclement weather like this because you usually have the entire scene to yourself and it's just beautiful. Like, it's quiet, got nothing out here but the birds and me, and just looking for different things to photograph. May not be like the most pristine mountain scene, but it's awesome to be out in this stuff anyways. One of the great advantages that you have with snow photography is definitely black and white, and especially those really artsy style of black and white photography where you have sticks coming out of the ground, very minimal scenes, and everything just kind of leans over in one direction. I kind of have that with a lot of these sticks in the background back here. I'll show you if I back up, of all these kind of sticks just folding over, and secluding those out with a telephoto lens is gonna be a great look here. Now, for something like this, I wanna get as much contrast in the composition as possible and keep it as clean and minimal as possible. So one of the tips I have for you is always be aware of where you're walking within the scene because you don't want your footprints to mess up how pristine and smooth the snow looks. You always want that to stay fresh and pristine when you're going out to shoot that. So this is the photo that I got. While I was taking this photo, I started to notice a lot of these small plants that are growing right along the bank of a frozen creek. And I'm reaching the point now in this challenge where I'm having trouble feeling my fingers anymore. So I don't know if I'm pressing the shutter button or not. So I have to rely on that 2-second timer on my camera. Now, I am standing in water that is pretty much slush at this point. Now, I'm wearing these rubber muck boots to help me stand in the water, but it is absolutely freezing around my feet. So I need to hurry up and get these shots done, but the wind is picking up as well, which with a macro shot like this makes it extremely difficult to do. Okay, there we go, guys. Three different shots with a 150 to 500 lens in this challenge for snow photography. Now that I can't feel my fingers anymore, my nose is completely numb. Let me know in the comments if I was able to achieve this challenge, and can I keep my 150 to 500 in the bag? Let me know in the comments section. Hopefully I get to keep it. To watch some more challenge videos, clip this card showing up on your screen right now. I'm going inside getting some hot chocolate.